there is a top menu. You've got jobs, you've got a company directory. Company directory is for the visibility of people who wish to advertise their business, who wish to advertise their organizations or institution. But that's not confined to only profitable businesses, but it also gives the opportunity for NGOs. And then we've got resumes. People in our universities can promote themselves. And then we've got 10 classifieds. People who wish to sell from the lowest thing to the biggest investment. People who want to economize by selling their vehicle or land or anything to economize their business or their well-being. That gives them the opportunity to do so. But the process was like this. Before you authorize job, you have to become a member. I think John and the PITAP team were foreseeing some ways of economizing this platform so that it's sustainable. Maybe an option is to have members pay a certain, maybe $5 to your advertising job. So in that way, we can continue to pay electricity and service for this, the hosting thing, because it's quite expensive to host that system on a 24-hour basis, year-round. Desirable. This is an ongoing thing. This is an ongoing thing. This one here. We want to achieve those things here. Once we go live, then it's not laborious, but I think we have to be methodical on how to make the website popular or how to make the website useful. So the website is now here. Yeah, there's some good images here, BSB Bank. Like Daddy Fog, this guy here. Yeah. Big images will need to be continually changing them to reflect. To sort of have a animated and up-to-date website. Anyway, that's the website. You can log into the website by typing long domain up there. Think of this one. Yeah. That's all for me.
And if we have, like, we have to have at least something that, and like, I agree with the idea that we will have country administrator, yeah. because how would we be able to, like this somehow is, to me it's like we are opening the whole, yeah, to everybody, but to scale down to our level and for the importance of our work as well as, you know, I think that is something that we will sometimes later get into. And the training component of it is also important for us.
The website actually looks quite robust. And I just want to pick on, I think, the intervention that the facilitator made with regards to how this actually interfaces with Chapter 7 of the draft agreement, which is yet to be signed. I think What you need to do is, instead of creating just like one portal for all the jobs, because the Chapter 7 is very, very clear in terms of which categories of jobs are supposed to actually come under the skills movement, MSG skills movement. And also, if we want to also attract just generally other jobs that don't fall under that domain, then we can also create just another one. But it's very clear that it's very important that I think we need to make sure that there is one line where those categories that members have already made commitments on should reflect, because in terms of processing that, it has a different system.
May I now request that we look at those recommendations and some of those feedback that the Hilton has captured on the PowerPoint. One is that contacting candidates to employees based on their native email client, such as Gmail browser-based, is to be configured into the specific field on email that the Hilton has captured. We will explore that so that when you click on that email address for that person you want to contact, you will just get the default email address you're using, Gmail or Yahoo, will come up. Or if it's Outlook, then it will be Outlook. We will try to change that. Kenton also got website external links. We insert into the website somewhere visible MSG's labor, investment, and immigration websites. For example, Kochi Invest, PNG Invest, VIPA, Vanuatu, Solomon Islands Investment Authority. This will be also included in the links. Number three, which I think will become a little bit later, in terms of sequencing for records, the need for translation. Although our friends from Blengez are not a party to the Malaysian Free Trade Area, so chapter 7 is not applicable to them. But for the purposes of facilitating movement of our MSG people for employment purposes, it's good to also have it translated in French or French MSG nationals in the
Bretonne. A website also that is, contains some information on employment opportunities as well.
Thank you for your presentation and feedback. At Solomon Islands and Vanuatu, I think we just, we are in agreement with everything that's been presented. At this stage, we just observe the work we have said.
Thank you, Jordan, and thank you, Kenton, for the presentation. Just an observation on how the website can be a very useful tool, especially for the monitoring and evaluation process. Particularly for the chapter 7 on labor mobility. I'm glad that Kenton has indicated that we can use that as to generate reports for what is going on with the labor, especially for the MSG region. And through these reports, members can also use that information to monitor and to evaluate to see how effective the labor is moving from one country to another. And especially if we have a reporting, I don't know what you call these, reporting dashboards to indicate any advertised job that has been contracted. Once contracted, countries would be interested to see whether the engagement was in accordance with the provisions under the Chapter 7 of the agreement. And that way it can help us to monitor the effectiveness of the provisions as utilized by each of the countries. And it will give a good base to report to each other in the platforms when members meet to discuss labor issues. So after a year or two or whatever occasional seasons, members will have specific data to report on in light of what is happening with labor mobility within the region.